Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel RF Design Basics. Today our topic of study is microwave amplifier design. In this we are going to study about the basic thing like power gain, available power gain, transducer power gain and unilateral transducer power gain. Let's start. So for any microwave amplifier design, we need one transistor having known S parameter, and there will be a source impedance with a voltage source and a load impedance for the complete amplifier design. Here, as we know from the S parameter topics, V1 plus V1 minus are input or incident wave variable and reflected wave variable at port 1. Similarly, V2 plus and V2 minus are incident and reflected wave variables at port 2. Let us consider two points in this amplifier, A and B. At point A, the total voltage is V1, which is summation of V1 plus and V1 minus, and total voltage at B is V2, which is summation of V2 plus and V2 minus. At point A, when we look into the source network, then the reflection coefficient is gamma S. When we look into the network, then reflection coefficient is gamma in. Similarly, at output port at point B, when we look into the network, the reflection coefficient is gamma out. When we look towards the load, the reflection coefficient is gamma L. Now let us define the different types of power gain. The first one is power gain, simple power gain, which is defined as the power delivered to the load to the power delivered to the input of the network. So it is the ratio of power delivered or dissipated to the load and the power input from the network. Similarly, we have available power gain, which is defined as the ratio of available power from the network and available power from the source. So this is the ratio of available power from the network and available power from the source. Similarly, we have third type of power gain, which is known as transducer power gain, and it is defined as PL by PAVS, where PL is power delivered to the load or power dissipated into the load to power available from the source. And we already know gamma S, which is reflection coefficient looking into the source, is ZS minus Z0 by ZS plus Z0, and reflection coefficient at load is ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0. We have also studied signal flow graph in our previous videos. In that, we have found that the input reflection coefficient for this kind of network is S11 plus S12 S21 gamma L by 1 minus S22 gamma L. Also, in the same way, we can find the output reflection coefficient gamma out as V2 minus by V2 plus, which is equal to S22 plus S12 S21 gamma S divided by 1 minus S11 gamma S. Here, as from the S parameters definition, V1 minus is S11 V1 plus S12 plus S12 V1 V2 plus. So V2 plus can be changed to gamma L into V2 minus, because gamma L is V2 plus by V2 minus. From here we can see gamma L, the reflection coefficient looking into the load. For this, the incidence will be V2 minus and the reflected will be V2 plus. And we know that the reflection coefficient is given by reflected one. So here for the load, V2 plus is reflected. So V2 plus and V2 minus will be incidence. So we can write V2 plus equal to gamma L V2 minus. So this is what we have replaced here in this expression. Also, V2 minus will be from the S parameter definition itself. V2 minus equal to S21 V1 plus S22 V2 plus, which is S21 V1 plus S22 gamma L V2 minus. So by taking this equation, we can further simplify and find a relation between this V1 plus and V2 minus. Yes, here also it is V2 minus and V2 minus. So we can find a relationship between them. So this relation is here. V2 minus equal to S21 V1 plus S22 gamma L V2 minus, which is directly taken from this equation. Now V2 minus and V1 plus, we have this relationship. That means if we know V1 plus, we can write V2 minus from this expression. Let us take the circuit again. In this circuit, if we are talking about point A, the source is Vs and impedance is Zs, and the Zin, which is looking from this port corresponding to gamma in, there will be a Zin, which will be the impedance, input impedance looking towards the network. So we can apply the voltage division, and this Vs will divide in two parts, one in Zs and one is across Zin. So that voltage is V1. So let's calculate V1. V1 will be from the voltage division Vs into Zin by Zs plus Zin. So by applying the voltage division at the point A, V1 is Vs Zin by Zs plus Zin. V1 is the total voltage, which is V1 plus V1 minus. Right side is Zin by Zs plus Zin. Again, the left side will be V1 plus gamma in into V1 plus. Because V1 minus and gamma in is having a relationship, and that relationship is gamma in equal to V1 minus by V1 plus. So in place of V1 minus, we can write gamma in into V1 plus. So V1 plus gamma in V1 plus equal to Vs. Then Zin equal to Z0 into 1 plus gamma in by 1 minus gamma in. This we can find by knowing the reflection coefficient formula, which was very simple. Zin minus Z0 by Zin plus Z0. So if you apply component to dividendo in this, this will give you Zin equal to Z0 into 1 plus gamma in by 1 minus gamma in. So similar thing we can apply for Zs as well in the denominator, and we can write in place of Zs, this is Zs, 1 plus gamma s by 1 minus gamma s into Z0. For Zin, 1 plus gamma in by 1 minus gamma in into Z0. So Z0 is common, it will be cancelled. Further simplification will give us V1 plus, which is Vs by 2, 1 minus gamma s by 1 minus gamma s gamma in. Viewers can do this derivation and find out the relation. Now let us take the average power delivered to the network, which is nothing but the input power to the network. So the input power to the network will be V1 plus square, which is the input voltage square, divided by 2Z0 into 1 minus gamma in square. So this is because there is input, at input there is some reflection, so this component will be multiplied in that. Otherwise, the normal formula for average power delivered is just half V1 plus square by Z0. Since there is reflection, so some of the power will be reflected back, so this coefficient need to be multiplied in that. And now let us replace this V1 plus with the found formula. V1 plus is Vs by 2, 1 minus gamma s by 1 minus gamma s gamma in. and get the expression for input power. So this is the expression for input power by replacing V1 plus as Vs into 1 minus gamma s by 1 minus gamma s gamma n. Since it is mod square, so everywhere we have to do mod square. Also, there was 2 in the denominator, which after a square it will become 4, and multiplied by 2 it is 8 Z0. So power delivered to the load. The next will be power delivered to the load. First we have found P in, now you'll find PL. Because we know that for calculating gains of gain of the amplifier, we need to find input power, power delivered to the load, power available from the network, and power available from the source. These 4 things we have to find, then we can define the gain of amplifier. So PL is given by, it will depend upon the V2 minus. Let's have a look on the circuit again. Here V2 minus is input to the load. So that means the power will be delivered using this voltage. So the power delivered will be V2 minus mod square by 2 Z0 into 1 minus gamma L square, since gamma L is the reflection coefficient of the load. So this component will be multiplied in this. So in place of V2 minus, as we have discussed previously, there is a relation between V2 minus and V1 plus, and that is S21 by 1 minus S22 gamma L is a term which will be multiplied in this. So let us apply that in PL equation and again replace this V1 plus with Vs by 2, 1 minus gamma S by 1 minus gamma S gamma L. By doing all this substitution, we will get PL equal to this Vs square by 8 Z0, 1 minus gamma L square, 1 minus gamma S mod square, S21 mod square, 1 minus S22 gamma L mod square, 1 minus gamma S gamma N mod square. So the power gain can be calculated by taking the ratio of PL, which is this, and P in, which is this. So by taking the ratio of PL and P in, we can calculate the power gain, which is given by this expression. Next is power available from the source. So power available from the source will be total input power when it is maximum. So when the maximum power is entering from the source, that will be the available power from the source. Due to the reflection at the input port at A, there some power might be reflected back, but still the power was available from the source. So to calculate that, we have to have the conjugate matching of these two, as we know that the for maximum power transfer, our impedance should be load impedance should be conjugate of each other. So here this at this point, this network will act as a load. So gamma S and gamma N should have conjugate matching. So when there will be conjugate matching, maximum power will be transferred from the source. That is called available power from the source. To calculate that, just we have to replace gamma N with gamma S conjugate or gamma S with gamma N conjugate. So input power maximum will be P in when gamma N equal to gamma S conjugate. So wherever gamma N is there, let's change it to gamma S conjugate. And then this can be simplified and the final expression is PAVS Vs square by Z0, 1 minus gamma S square, 1 minus mod gamma S square. Now we are going to calculate available power from the network. So again we will have a look into the network and we'll understand what is available power from the network. Let's say the power has been, maximum power has been transferred from here. So first condition should be gamma S and gamma N should be conjugately matched, then only maximum power will be transferred through this. And then second condition is to have maximum available, maximum power delivered to the load impedance and the Z out. This should be in the conjugate matching. That means gamma L and gamma out should be conjugately matched, apart from gamma S, gamma in also. So let us apply both the condition together to find how much power is available from the network. That will be the available power from the network. For that, we have to replace gamma L with gamma L with gamma out conjugate. And by replacing, we can find this expression. Wherever we have gamma L in PL, we will replace with gamma out conjugate. And wherever we have gamma in, that also must be calculated for this condition, gamma L equal to gamma out conjugate. So when we calculate this for gamma L and gamma out conjugate, this particular factor 1 minus gamma in gamma whole square will convert to this, and by replacing this, some of the factors will be cancelled out and we will have power available from the network as this, which can be applied to find available power gain and the transducer power gain. As we know, available power gain is PAVN, available from the network, power available from the source. By taking these two ratio, we will get the available power gain. Similarly, for transducer power gain, PL, which is already calculated previously, and PAVS is also calculated. Let us take the ratio of PL and PAVS and we will get the transducer power gain. There are some special cases we are going to discuss now. When there is gamma L is 0 and gamma S is 0, which is known as input and output, both are matched for zero reflection coefficient. So in that case, if we put gamma L and gamma S 0 in transducer power gain equation, gamma L is 0, gamma S is 0, here also gamma S 0, gamma L 0, it will make everything 1 except this S21 square. So the transducer power gain will be just S21 square, which is given by this. Another special case we can say is unilateral transducer power gain, which is represented by ZTU. Unilateral transducer means the transmission is only in one direction. That means from port 2 to 1, there is no transmission. So if the transmission is unidirectional, so S12 will be 0. If S12 is 0, and we have seen the expression for S11 for the gamma in and gamma out in terms of S11. Here if we put S12 0, this entire quantity will become 0. So gamma in is S11. Similarly, if you put S12 0 here, entire quantity will be 0 and gamma out will be S22. Therefore, gamma in is S11 for unilateral transducer power gain and gamma out is S22. So power gain can be calculated by replacing all gamma in and gamma out as S11 and S22. So you can see here everything is replaced and the unilateral power transducer power gain is given by this expression. We can also write this GT expression, the transducer power gain expression, which we have written here in the separate components. So 1 minus gamma S square by 1 minus gamma S gamma in mod square. This is input property of the, or you can say source property of the transistor amplifier. So let's say this is source gain. Similarly, 1 minus gamma L square by 1 minus S22 gamma L mod square. This is the property of output side. So this is known as load gain, and one more component is S21 square, so that is denoted by Z0. So basically GT is multiplication of these three separate power gain. One is source power gain, then due to the transistor power gain, and then load power gain. So in these are the equations which can be used to calculate different types of power gain. In my next video, I will be making the stability circle using the Smith chart, and we will understand which type of loads are stable to design an amplifier. Thank you.